Hi, this is Jennifer, and I've been asked to do a website evaluation for Tia Rosa. On the left-hand side, we have the website Greater Report. On the right-hand side, we have the physical website itself. For this particular case, we are going to be using Website Greater. However, there are two different reports. I just kind of want to show you the difference in between them. One of them is Marketing Greater. The other one is Website Greater. I'll let that report run. Website Greater was developed by a company called HubSpot in conjunction with Google, Alexa, Facebook, Twitter, and some other website evaluation tools and companies. The focus of this particular report is really on the architecture and infrastructure of the website, how well everything under the hood works. So a lot of times when we're concentrating on a website, you'll see people really, really heavily focus on design, which is more of the front-end presentation letter instead of the entire site beginning to end, meaning from that framework all the way through to the front end of the site. So a lot of times what happens is we wind up with a really pretty online brochure that has no brain. It doesn't really have any value with the exception of if you were to hand out a business card or if somebody was going to go to the website from other branding and marketing investments that you have out there, that they would be able to see this really pretty website. So that's kind of the situation we're dealing with here. Graphically, of course, there's been a lot of emphasis put on graphics. I'm going to go ahead and inspect element, and we're going to go check out the site. It's a very, very small website. This is not much done from an SEO standpoint. Looks like we've started to use some social media widgets on the site. The header one tag is a logo and so forth. So this is a really tiny website, just a giant image basically. If we were to remove that, that's all we have is this large image. So the website grades 45 out of 100, and that's very, very low. If you were to have a brand new website built and it was built properly, it should be around 50, 60. And that's if it's 2 days online. And then outside of that, you really, you know, over maybe a 90-day period with the right developer and SEO team, you should be able to get that website up into the 70s. Within a six-month period, you should be in the 80s. Within 9 to 12 months, you should be in the 90s. And then you start moving over into the Marketing Grader report, which your Marketing Grader report is 29 out of 100. So quite a few points, about 15 points lower than this one. The website is a static site, so there's no integrated blog. And there's really not a lot of content to the site at all. It's very, very image heavy, which unfortunately the way Google works is Google is deaf and blind, so it cannot see the beautiful pictures, and it cannot hear. So those things are not going to help you with getting that page rank. What you'll notice is there's very few index pages on Google. So if you think about Google as a big file system or a directory, a filing cabinet, the more pages you have inside that filing cabinet, the better. The more real estate you own. So that's really going to help. You'll notice that the readability level is showing that the page does not contain enough content for meaningful analysis, and that's really because there's no content on the page. I understand the reason for designing a page like this, but what you might want to do is consider having more of an integrated blog below the fold. So underneath here is really using this space for content-rich information that's going to help this website get ranked and properly placed and positioned on search engines. So that's very, very important. So none of the content can be read on the site. So we're going to move down to metadata. The website has to have the proper label and description in order to be placed inside a filing system, inside a search engine. The only thing that we're telling Google that this website is about is Tia Rosa, tradition you can taste. And then you can tell that the whoever built the website used some type of a template system because it says description content, which is, that's just something didn't get filled out. So your page title or your metadata at the homepage page title area, which I'll go inspect element because I want to show you where this is. Here's the header data information. There are no keywords. So you'll see this description content equals description content. That's what this is right here. The title of the site is Tia Rosa, Tradition You Can Taste, which you'll see right here. No keywords, no description. Let's go see who this is. We're going to go look and see real quick. I'm curious, so I want to go check out what this is. So this is your web design company. So the web design company that has done your site is actually the only thing that's really being optimized here is their site. Okay, so we'll go look at headings. Same thing with your headings. The only heading used on the whole site is Tia Rosa, Tradition You Can Taste. Tia Rosa is a very prominent brand. The website's domain name is tiarosa.com. So this actually does not need to be in your page title. It does not need to be the only heading tag. If you can imagine reading a newspaper, your heading tags are how people navigate throughout the paper, and here throughout the website. So some things that are most important are the words tortilla. That would be very important, or tortilla maker, or any other primary searches. So there's lots of things here. Fun facts, how to eat a taco, how to eat a burrito. There's lots of cool little pieces of content, but the way that it was designed and developed, none of this is indexable. This would be much more prominent in a blog. Now, every single page on the entire website actually was given the exact same page title and the exact same description. So when you go look through here, you'll see products, howto.php. That has no value to Google. If we go look from the /promotions, no value. Recipes, /recipes. If this was not embedded in an iframe, actually, let me go look before I speak. There's your padding. Put inside a div. Okay, so it's inside a div, but this would be a great area for you to have blog content. There's tons of things you could be doing. You could be having people post their recipes. You could be leveraging Facebook and Twitter. You should be blogging about those and so forth. There's so many different options you guys have for developing content, publishing it through your website then pushing it out to your social media networks, and that way no matter how far it travels, they always come back. So really it's extending the reach, expanding the reach even through your social media networks. Let's go see how we're doing on okay, so these right here, share on Facebook and share on Twitter, these almost look like they should be follow me icons. So social media, actually, you know what? I'll come back to that. Let me come back to that. Your website has been online for 13 years, 4 months, and 3 weeks. That's fantastic. You guys do have a domain name that expires in 7 months and 1 week. You need to get that renewed as quick as possible. One, because if someone has a back order, but two, because in Google's eyes, all it knows is when are you closing. So it wants to know that you're going to be online for at least another 2 years, which of course we all know you're going to be. But that's a quick fix and something I would get done right away. Also, whoever set up your website, they did not set up a 301 redirect, which goes against Google's webmaster requirements. Right now, Google thinks tiarosa.com with and without a www are two different sites. So that is not going to help you from a search engine standpoint as well. Now, after having been online for over 13 years, the challenge is because of all these things that are technically wrong with the infrastructure of the site, your page rank is very low, 4.3 out of 10. Page rank really is about link authority, popularity, and trust as it relates to Google's page rank. So this is something that really needs to happen, or be fixed. One way to do that is by correcting the architecture of the site. Another way to do that is by adding content on a frequent basis. And the third way to do that is through an off-page SEO plan, a backlinking program. And that's really going to help by getting listed in directories, social sites, having comments on other blogs. There's lots of ways to generate backlinks. But really it stems from listening to your community, engaging your community, generating content, and then pushing that content from your site out to your social networks. Right now you only have 9 backlinks. It's almost like only having 9 testimonials after being in business for 13 years. Now I know you have thousands and thousands. However, in Google's eyes, it can't hear your testimonials. It can't hear people's feelings about a particular brand. So the only thing you have to go on is a robot analyzing your site and the millions and trillions of websites out there and trying to figure out who trusts you. And that's done through these backlinks, such as Bimbo Bakeries. Now, mobile optimization. Your website, when it was designed, was not designed considering that mobile devices, tablets were going to be so huge. So right now, the use of mobile devices and tablets is increasing at an extremely rapid rate. So your website does have to be designed to be able to work on mobile devices. Next thing, social media integration. You do have Facebook. Where are they? Let me go back to the front end of the site. So it's very interesting kind of how disjointed all of the social media integration is. Social media needs to be integrated from 4 different fashions. One, people have to have the ability to follow you. So on the website, there's really no way to do that I can tell, nothing prominent. 2, people have to have the ability to share your content on their Facebook. You do have 2 buttons, just for 2, which they're kind of in an odd place. This is normally where you would follow somebody versus sharing content. And there's not a lot of content to share. The 3rd is the ability to like, and that's more of an SEO function. You'll see the like on Facebook. And then the 4th is social media publishing, which comes from generating interesting content, publishing that content out to your social media networks. That way, you always start from the center hub. You bring people, you push that content out to all of your social sites very seamlessly, and then you bring them back into the middle, which is where conversions take place. So those are things that definitely need to be corrected on the site as well. There is no RSS feed. There's no conversion form. So there's really no way to subscribe to the site, but there's not a lot of reason to now because of the lack of content. So that's really going to help as well. No conversion forms as far as being able to generate traffic and then convert into possible prospects, possibly new buyers and so forth. The website needs a lot of work in that perspective as well. And the last component is traffic. There's just not enough traffic to really make this thing a kind of screaming or humming marketing engine. Now I'm going to flip over real quick to marketing grader because I want you to get an idea of this. So it's at 29 out of 100. Let me let this refresh. Which there's quite a big drop. When you get into the marketing grader, it's going to be talking about blogging, content generation, lead capture, conversions, and so forth. So, of course, the game changes. Once you get the architecture, the framework, and the infrastructure correct on the website, then you really have to start looking at what are your behaviors, what are the activities, how are you leveraging the technology. Your website is everything. Make sure that your social media content, interactions, everything is starting and ending with the site. You definitely don't want to be out in the cloud or leveraging social media but not bringing it back home. So I hope that this was helpful. I appreciate you giving us the opportunity to be able to review your site and provide you with a little bit of feedback, and we look forward to talking with you shortly. Again, I'm Jennifer Bagley. Thanks so much, and we'll talk to you soon.